thank all today's performers. The International Year of the Family reinforces family values, not just for a year, but for our children's children. For our society to flourish, families must flourish. Let's look after families.
Tribute to the Australian family, the halftime entertainment for the Melbourne Cricket Ground. Back with the second half after this.
$3 special.
Saturday, buy one chicken and get another for only $3.
Awesome value.
Sure, you've got the autographed Eagles photos. You've got the official scarf. And the beanie. And the jumper. You've probably even got a first issue Eagles cushion. But no one. No one can call themselves a true Eagles fan unless they get their own copy of the limited edition, once only grand final souvenir edition of tomorrow's Sunday Times. Don't miss it.
Aye, man. Hey, you know afternoon tea is now very cool. Oasis also come in iced teas made with natural fruit juice. Only problem is, now we're drinking our tea cool. What we're going to do with our tea cools is... Good idea, man.
Broke my windscreen.
Broke my windscreen. Now hold me, what shall I do?
Simply phone us, Instant Windscreens.
Instant Windscreens fit windscreens, side and rear glass to all types of vehicles. Install van windows and even apply window tinting for cooler driving. All work is fully guaranteed. And with Instant's innovative Repair It, you may not even need a new windscreen.
Until now, you put your money in a term deposit and it just sat there. Now One Bank has launched a term deposit that's one of the most flexible and hard-working investments you could hope for. Not only does your interest rate grow every 7 months to a staggering 10%, but you can add extra money or take it out, so you simply can't lose. Open a Bankwest Breakthrough Term Deposit now. Your money couldn't be in a better state.
More West Australians choose Aquatechnics pools than any other. No wonder, with quality like this. It's Aquatechnics' commitment to quality that made them the only fiberglass pool company in Western Australia to receive a quality-endorsed company certificate from Standards Australia. An internationally recognised standard, and your guarantee of a quality pool from a quality company. Visit Aquatechnics today, and like most West Australians, you'll choose an Aquatechnics pool.
Most big insurance companies give you one big bill each year. At HBF Home and Car, we'll let you pay half yearly if you want, or quarterly if you like, or monthly. In fact, HBF Health members can even pay weekly. So what are you going to do when your next insurance bill arrives? You're better by far with HBF Home and Car.
Qantas scoreboard at half-time in the grand final. West Coast 8-12, Geelong 5-7. More than 2,000 people are in the Birdswood showroom in Western Australia, and they're cheering home their beloved West Coast Eagles. Robert Dipper, Domenico, the Big Dipper, and Neil Curley on the boundary line. Dipper, West Coast must be pretty happy.
Well, they are at the moment, Bruce. It's not over yet. A breeze did pick up in that last quarter, which helped the Eagles. And, of course, Geelong will now kick with the breeze. But the good news for the Eagles, some of the playmakers aren't their champions, like Jason Ball playing good at centre forward, Waterman on the wing, of course, a young Tony Evans kicking two goals and those two important hands on.
Yeah, well, Malcolm Blight, of course, as we realise, he's got terrible problems. If he can get his Geelong side up, he's a miracle man. They've got real problems all over the ground.
Second half starts, 8-12, 5-7, Barnes out of the centre. Geelong needing two quick goals, no question about that. They've got to put some pressure back on West Coast. Pike's kick, bouncing ball. Steve Hocking has had a quiet one. Chris Lewis has been brilliant. Amble inside, gives Henny the run of it, picked it up superbly, ran into Evans, goes to ball. Could kick a goal, but sprays it completely and out of bounds on the fall. They've had their chances, West Coast, to have destroyed Geelong. They haven't quite put them away.
Particularly Jason Ball, who has been quite effective, but he has let a lot of opportunities slip through his hands.
He's kicked 2 points, Ball, and one out of bounds on the fall. O'Reilly goes out wide. Mansfield has been Geelong's best. Kemp, who would be in front of the Norm Smith, was voted on at half-time. Brilliant first half by the playmaker. The best and fairest of the club in their premiership year.
Inside information. We're voting today, Bruce. Right at the back, it's taken by Couch. A high floater down towards half forward. Coming up to mid at McKenna. Tries to go back to Worsfold. Hard against the line. It's out of bounds on the full. Rather untidy. Riccardi's got it. Goes for distance. In front down there was Mensch. It runs free behind. Brownless has got it. Tudor, cleverly played, got it down to Couch on his left foot. He goes for home and misses to the near side. Worth a try. Ball Couch. Solid so far. 9 possessions.
Both Geelong and the West Coast have lined up pretty similar to the way they finished the first half.
McKenna finds Pike, is at left half back, pulls it back for Jakovic. Jakovic decides to go for a run. His second bounce carries him down towards the wing. He kicks towards half forward. Heddy's in front, McGrath from behind. Brewer roving the pack. The ball was taken away by Wilson. 52 metres out, down towards full forward. Back goes Mansfield with courage. Great mark.
Is he, along with Riccardi, have probably been Geelong's best players today.
Decides to go long. Matera can get back and put pressure on Hickmott. Matera holds it up. Hickmott tries to get rid of him. Banfield gets it back out. His worst fault at centre wing. A centering kick. Big fly by Heddy and a terrific mark. Had the drop on them.
Yeah, I thought Tim McGrath could have done a bit better. He appeared to go for the mark himself. But when you're going against Brett Heddy, who's an outstanding overhead mark for his size, defence must be at the forefront of your mind.
Heddy today with one goal. He's kicked one out of bounds on the fall and a behind. He missed an easy shot in the second term. Goes through his ritual, setting himself up before he shoots for goal.
Interesting that both Colbert and Brown are still on the interchange bench. For a side that's well down, Blight really hasn't shown much adventure with his use of the interchange.
Heady to shoot from about 40 metres out. Well, they'll be disappointed. He's missed some chances as Heady. He really should have kicked 3 goals. Mainwaring injured on the bench with Bond and Hines. So Geelong hang in by default, really, at 8-13 to 5-8.
O'Reilly thumping kick towards the outer side. Turnbull fisting away from Barnes. Bairstow a little slow. Flung it on the boot. Carries the centre line. Taken by Wills. Gets it back to Pickering. Pickering kicks down towards full forward. Up comes Ablett. Got a hand to it. It spills to Mensch. He snaps and misses. Quick transference there for the Cats. No doubt they talked about their kicking in at halftime. There's Gary Hocking. They're strapping that leg again. I think they are. The strapping was off when he came back on the ground. I thought for a moment they may have given up as far as he was concerned for the afternoon. Jakovic takes the mark, plays on. Sends Waterman into space. This is dangerous for Geelong. Waterman can run at the defence now. Still he goes. He could score from here, Waterman. He runs to the 50, settles, goes for home. It's a good-looking kick. Mansfield gets down there, dropped the mark. Across the line it goes. The behind. No conviction now when their good players like that man are making mistakes and limping.
Ball seemed to hold up on him just for a moment, didn't he? Didn't quite time it right. 8-14, 5-9. What can Geelong do? O'Reilly goes long. They've given away that short ploy. Cost them 2 goals. The thump away from Barnes. Oh, too slow, Pickering. Does get his kick away. Into the centre, a wrestle there. Bouncing ball. Kemp's won most of these. Bairstow needs to lead by example. Ablett sets himself, hasn't been able to get off the ground. got a bit of a push. Hart loves this, doesn't he? Runs away. Will kick the ball close to the boundary line. He'll probably hope it goes out. Brewer and also Waterman out of play. Well, Gary Ablett again unable to get off the ground today. Can't remember him leaping for one against North Melbourne last week. Bairstow thumped away by Jakovic. Pickering at centre wing. Worsfold underneath it. Kemp will be pretty happy to run it over. And it'll be a throw in. Geelong in attack, but about 75 metres from goal. It seems such a long way home for them at the moment. Hines, who missed out in 92, sitting with Bond, a rookie. And Mainwaring, who must be desperately disappointed. Free kick for the Cats. It'll come back to Pickering. Ablett motionless in the goal square.
Margin 23 points. Now Ablett moves. The kick well in short. It was touched, I think, in the direction of Wills, who couldn't control it. It goes across the boundary line. So a throw in. About 35 metres from the Cats' attacking goal. And they desperately need a goal here. Barnes, who's tried hard for them, goes up in front. Hard at close quarters, very close quarters. Got it to Kemp. Who had the ball? Well, the umpire has decided to penalise the West Coast Eagles, and Couch will get the free. Somebody, one of the Eagles, had it in there. Fell to the ground, and holding the ball was the decision. So Paul Couch will kick it goal from about 40 out. He's going at his second. Tries to come back, but it won't. Off hands, I thought, against the post, wasn't it? Brownless has taken the mark. Interesting one. Brownless has got the ball deep in the pocket.
He's got to make a decision here. Either he goes back and tries to kick the goal, or he passes. Once there's no passing options on, he's got to kick it.
Around he comes, pulls it back. He's got it.
In the past, some people had to go to extraordinary lengths to get something extra out of a bank.
Over here, Mr. Kelly.
With Privilege Plus, Challenge Bank is happy to give you around $1,000 in extras.
$1,000?
And no transaction fees.
Free legal advice.
Privilege Plus. It's why Challenge Bank customers are around $1,000 a year better off. Bye-bye.
I can hang up this stupid helmet.
Oh, Mr. Kelly?
Yes, miss.
Not all banks are the same.
To be sure.
Brownless has got both Geelong's goals since quarter time. He kicked their only goal in the second quarter. He gets the all-important first goal here. 8-14 to 6-9. Are the Cats coming back? They need another one to top it off. Bairstow runs hard. Free kick, though. Oh, that's awful play. That's 50 metres against the captain. The umpire was in a very good position. Given up the free kick to Pike. And now Pike can attack from 60 metres. Heady running loose, now picked up by McGrath. Pike looking for a short option. Not quite close enough to goal. He's got Kemp short, he goes in there. They gain about 6 metres. Kemp at about 54 metres. Turnbull lurking in the pocket. Now goes short to Turnbull, gets him. They're inside 50 suddenly.
Just working it away, working it around, getting inching closer to the goals. Pretty ordinary defence by Geelong. Those two short passes have been on for 20 seconds before they delivered them.
Very patient, aren't they?
Have to plug the holes in a situation like that. Make sure the gaps are sealed. Turnbull to kick. He'll kick right on 50. Good kick off the boot. Just fading away. It's a behind. 8-15 West Coast. 6-9 Geelong. Now here's Pike's free kick. Now you'll see. Well, Pike made the most of it, but it was something there anyway. And the umpire was right on it. Starting to rain at the MCG. 8-15, 6-9.
O'Reilly. Down the middle this time. Turnbull from behind, fist away, taken by Pickering, across to Couch. Can they rally? Couch towards half forward. Awkward looking kick, that one. Fisted away from Mensch by Jakovic. It fell forward. Over the ball is Waterman, a good player since he replaced Mainwaring. McKenna gets it out to Wilson. Wilson boots it down towards half forward. McGrath leads in the race. The boundary line is close. And a friend of McGrath's. He runs it across, and a boundary throw in. Now towards left half forward for the West Coast Eagles. Hocking is off the bench, at least for a moment. Will they try him again? Hooked behind by Turnbull. Eventually it comes to Barnes. Good hand pass. Falling to the ground, he got it to McGrath. McGrath's probing kick. Big pack. Brownless was high. And away they come once more. This is McKenna. He got it from Jakovic. He comes to the wing. Kemp gets an obliging bounce. Kicks it down towards half forward. In front, Evans. It was fisted away by Mansfield. Pickering. That was a very strong tackle applied by Wilson. Taken by Evans. The kick past half forward now. Ball runs onto it. Loose ball favours him. It sits for him. 25 metres out. It's a goal.
Creation, the mother of all invention, taking one simple idea, protecting and nurturing it for the next generation. We give you the all-new Mitsubishi Star Wagon, or as we'd like to call it, the mothership. Please consider.
15-6-9. Ball's goal stretches it to 24 points again. Barnes, who delivered a brilliant handball. Gary Hocking back on. Pickering. You see that there's a swirly. Here's Hocking from 55. Measures it. Abler gets underneath it. Brennan with him. It's out of bounds in the pocket. Brennan has done very well on Abler, as Mickey Martin did last week. Abler going into this grand final with 15 goals in his three finals matches this season. He kicked nine here in 1989. He and Morris Rioli, the only two men to have lost a grand final and won the Norm Smith medal for the best on the ground. Barnes, Jakovic has been good in this quarter, taken off in by Mensch. They appeal Geelong for holding the ball. Will they get it? I think they might. No. Something's happening down below. Free kick. It's going against Brownless to McIntosh, and all that would have happened with the ball. And someone's been laid out. Behind play.
Billy, I think, just fainted, Bruce. Just went down looking for a free kick. Billy Brownless. Pickering looks as if he's about to come off the ground after this throw-in to be replaced by Paul Brown.
Geelong by four goals behind. Here's Brewer. He's been quiet. Good tackle on him by Kemp. Hocking. Brewer's hip and shoulder okay. Worsfold did that beautifully. Jakovic, a big quarter so far. Back to centre wing. Mansfield. Claims it. Well, if Kemp's the best for West Coast, there's no question who the best is for Geelong. It's this young man, Michael Mansfield, the 23-year-old.
From half-back towards half-forward, Barnes and Brownless, one of them. Barnes in front, I fancy. Handley's coming off the ground. Is he? No. He's okay, but the worse for wear. Meantime, Barnes has got the ball. About 80 metres from goal. Brownless offers the lead. That's a very good mark. Very good. Initially, Barnes wanted Brownless to take the kick for the mark because I think he's a better kick. Smart thinking by Barnes, but the next best thing to do is kick it to Billy yourself. So Brownless, from about 35 metres out, has got two. Very, very big kick, this one. Down by 24 points, the Cats. Brownless, very effective. Steers it through.
The basic unit in technology is not the bit. The basic unit is you. And the road. And the air. A shoe and the stars and the moonlight. Air square. Well, the basic unit in technology is not the bit, but the body.
18 points, the difference. Malcolm Blight looks on. Billy Brownless has kicked Geelong's last three goals. He's got all of them since quarter time. It's getting very dark here at the MCG.
I really need to get a couple in a row now. Big lift in the midfield. Bairstow, Couch. Got to get the ball out of the centre. Hocking, he's in there. He's on one leg. That cork in the thigh is only going to continue to bleed. You see it on screen, heavily strapped. Strapping won't be doing much. He's had his hand on a couple of balls, it'll be all important.
Geelong trying to rally, 9-15, 7-9. Turnbull wins it out of the centre. Here's Kemp attacking. kicks it out wide. Evans goes hard with Mansfield. Good tackle in the end. It's got him. Well, he's having a day out, isn't he? That was Pike, I should say, with Mansfield. It's going to take Pike on too. Having a wonderful match. To half forward, Minch, big fly. Tudor tried to read it. Jakovic straight to Couch. Worsfold getting back. Bouncing ball. Ablett will go for Worsfold. Hard, he did. Took his eye off the footy. Charged the captain. Won't worry Worsfold too much.
Yes, and Ablett, just knowing that the ball's going to go out of bounds. He didn't hit him. He certainly tried, though.
Barnes, Tudor. Evans and Kemp. Kemp again. Supreme. Free kick as it coming back to West Coast against Tudor, I think. And it'll go to Tony Evans. It looks like his eye might have closed. Gary Hocking, we believe, the offender there. Now McKenna, clever. Steps around Wills, kicks at the centre wing. Ball sets himself. Hinckley from the side. Oh, Kemp read it beautifully, as he's done all day. Strides away with three bounces. Centering kick to Willis. You don't get any better than that. The pressure of the grand final to kick your head, hold it up, lead at the last moment and hit him on the chest. This will hurt Geelong if Lewis goals here.
Interesting though, he ignored the lead of Sumic. Ended up going for the longer one of Lewis. As Banfield comes off the ground and Chris Mainwaring comes back onto the arena.
Raining steadily now at the MCG. Lewis goes from 50. Lewis, like so many of his teammates today, has missed 9-16 to 7-9. They were 4-3 at quarter time. They've kicked 5 goals, 13 since then, West Coast.
Now put them away. Here's O'Reilly. Down the middle, Turnbull from behind, fisted forward, taken by Couch, who's lifting. Couch in the centre square, goes down towards half forward, ill directed. Hart's there, knocked away by Tudor, who's got the ground speed. Waterman in trouble. Jakovic, he peels off half back. Jakovic towards half forward, not a good kick though. Only went about 15 metres. Rebound opportunity. Bruin gets it to Mintz to Tudor. He's 55 metres out, sets it up. Brownless in from the side, flies. Fisted away by McIntosh. Ablett leads back in the race. Great desperation. Mainwaring got there in the nick of time, despite the lunge by Ablett. The ball is out of bounds. Boundary throw in. 9-16 to 7-9. Barnes is there with him. Turnbull in the gloom. It falls behind them. Turnbull on his knees, slaps it out. Mike Sockers off the ground. Up towards centre half back. Brewer claimed, gets the kick away towards full forward. McIntosh got his fingertips to it. McKenna a little toe poke. Worsfold set hard a task under pressure. He gets it out of the goal square and it comes to Mainwaring in space.
So often does it, Mainwaring, in the right place at the right time. He's come off the interchange bench. That a wobbly one. Brown, who hasn't had a kick since he came on 5 minutes ago, would love a good touch here. He gets it, has time to do something. Just blazes badly, gives Jakovic the run. Well played though from the side by Brewer. Back to Jakovic, good tackle on him. Geelong are giving it everything here. They know that this is their chance. Kemp on the end of it. Usually keeps a cool head. Runs around Mitch. He is supreme, isn't he, Dean Kemp? A third bounce. Gets hold of it. Bad kick, but it should come off Evans. Brown's got to go for him. Evans rides it beautifully to Wilson, who kicked 2 second quarter goals. Steady and kick beauty. Well played. Waterman should goal. Goes for it. Looks at it. Hooks it. And they cannot deliver the knockout.
Sumic slaps his thigh in disgust. He's been ignored again.
I should have. They had to have a shot, Jared. 35 metres.
Well, he didn't have to. He could have gone back simply. He rushed it.
He's kicked 3 points and run out of bounds on the forward.
It's been an outstanding play. He's been the best 6 players for the West Coast.
O'Reilly again for distance. Turnbull over Barnes. Gets it on the ground again. Wilson over the left shoulder. Kemp. 45 metres out, Dean Kemp. Will this be a goal? Yes, it will. A long time coming.
Aye, man. Hey, you know afternoon tea is now very cool. Oasis also come in iced teas made with natural fruit juice. Only problem is, now we're drinking out with tea cool. What we're going to do with our tea cool is
good idea, man.
26-point margin. Kemp's first goal for the game's at 22 touches. Tudor has it ripped off. West Coast are going hard.
Oh, Evans.
High tackle. Matera. To Hart. To Turnbull. To full forward. Front's Heady. He's kicked one already. Snaps. That's it, you'd reckon. You would say that was it. They're cheering at Burswood and they're cheering in here. The West Coast make its move for a second premiership.
Peter Matera getting involved, been well beaten to date by Riccardi. It's a bit of a surprise to see him burst onto the scene and kick a couple of quick goals. Once again, you can't do anything but sing the praises of Brett Heady. Such a talented player. Started the season beautifully, had a flat spot in the middle, but has really put together a final series to remember.
Geelong on their knees now as the fairy tale over. To 94, Mainwaring taken high. That was very crude. Mainwaring to get the free. By Bairstow, he needs to get in and get the ball, and Brothers ball takes the mark right on the 50. It's all one-way traffic at the moment. And this young man has had a very productive afternoon. He was a priority draft pick for the West Coast Eagles. They've had an eye for talent over the seasons. That's a long kick. They contest a couple of meters out. Mansfield, the presence of mind, a fist of proof for a behind. The lead increased for the Eagles. 11-18 to 7-9. The umpire had a word to Mark Bairstow. Here's O'Reilly.
Handley calling for it. As Dennis said, they're on their knees now, Geelong. Handley in the front spot. Barnes, high tackle, free kick. About the Eagles, they won't release the grip now. Gee, had his head or neck nearly pulled off there, Barnes. To centre half forward. Bad kick, turnover again, Pike. Mistakes coming from Geelong now. Kemp again. 23 touches out to Waterman. Good half volley. Mansfield's got him. Play on call. Matera. Riccardi's done a job on him today. It's been terrific. Still Matera. Taken off it by Mansfield. Free kick, Matera. Riccardi down and out, has not moved for about 20 seconds. Looks to be in trouble. Matera to the pocket. Well played, Mansfield again. Out of play. Now Riccardi picking himself up. We take a replay and see.
Just got the knee. Matera left knee right in the scone.
Free kick to the Cats at halfback. Cat fans roar their approval. Ironic cheers. They reckon they're hard done by, but West Coast 11-18 to 7-9. Kemp, who's had a dislocated finger by the look of it, has had it to push back into place. Brown gets it.
33 points the Eagles' way. Stephen Hawking goes over the top. Riccardi back in the action. He likes the situation, Riccardi, running down towards half forward. 75 metres out and closing. He's about 55 metres out as he kicks. Down towards full forward, Bradless, almost a one-hander, perhaps he would have been better advised to leave it. Tudor was pushed, back comes Bradless, no free kick, Ablett's over the ball, could be holding the ball, he needs to be careful, the umpire calls for it.
You've got to say that Geelong have probably done what they set out to do, and that's keep the wings quiet. Mainwaring and Matera have had no effect, although Waterman, his Mainwaring's replacement, has done well.
Turnbull towards the boundary, picked up by Wills. Good effort from there. They'll contest about 5 metres out. Djakovic, standing tall, got a fist on that one and forced a behind.
I guess they've also kept Djakovic fairly quiet. McKenna's had an excellent day once again. But such is the strength, the overall evenness of this side, that even the best laid game plans can fall apart.
Well, given the Brownlow voting, we can't rule Matera out for the Smith medal just yet.
That's right.
McKenna from fullback goes long this time. Djakovic the target, Brewer, well played, to Wills, goes for goal from 50, bangs it right back there, is it over the line? It is, it's a behind, 7-11 to 11-18. Well, what Geelong fans would do for a couple of Gary Ablett goals in a hurry.
Or a couple of Gary Ablett's.
Yes, 84 to 53. Not much from the champ today. Not that champ. The Geelong champ. Here's McKenna taking his time. They've been relentless, haven't they, West Coast? Typical. Again, Jakovic. Brewer again did a good job. Forces it forward. Wills can't quite get it past Pipe. Kemp sits on it and lets it go out of play. Just reads the play so brilliantly, Dean Kemp. Had knee problems earlier this year. Missed two or three games in a row. 31-point margin. 3 minutes remaining.
At the top, Turnbull. Back towards the boundary. And across the line it goes. So the Cats need something. Did it quickly, just over 3 minutes till three-quarter time. Misting rain falling. Barnes decisively taken by McKenna. Hasn't got the ball. No free kick. Played on and did very well. Got it to Pike. Hard against the line. He kicks towards the wing. McGrath comes storming across. Ballingan attempt to mark. Couldn't. It ricochets across the line.
Very unobtrusive, Don Pike, but once again doing his job effectively. 17 touches in the middle and containing a valuable player.
Barnes, big spring, thumps it away. Cats controlled it to the advantage of hocking to Bairstow. Bairstow 70 metres out, looks for Ablett, got hands to it, couldn't hang on. Can he find it on the ground, or more particularly, can he control it? He's got plenty of company down there. Worsfold and Brennan. It comes to Hinkley, who snaps and kicks it behind.
Get back to five goals, Geelong. 30 points the difference. 11-18 to 7-12. McKenna wide. Got Matera. Finds him. Beautiful kick. Matera at 50 metres defensive side. Just seven kicks and a couple of handballs. Centre wing. Good long kick. Looking for Wilson. Well played at the back by Brown. Still Brown. Very well played. But a bad kick there by Brownless. Under pressure, taken by Hart. Good rebound again by Hart today. 13 touches after this. Good distance, centre wing. McGrath at the back. He's had his hands full again. Very different opponent to last week. This time Heady with Carey last week. McGrath bangs it back, hoping for a Minch mark. Or maybe Barnes from the side, Turnbull. Jakovic just crashes his way through to Evans. Evans to half forward, Lewis in the front spot. Stephen Hocking with Lewis, just trying to hold him up. Hocking tries to run away, well played. To Bairstow. Too slow, much too slow, Bairstow. West Coast to try and rebound. Gary Hocking struggling, obviously, to the boundary line and out of play.
Well, you do have those kinds of days, unfortunately. For Mark Bairstow, he's having one in the grand final.
Throw in on the 50. Ball and Handley. Handley over the top. Here's Lewis. Comes to the boundary line. They stay off him. He settles and kicks it down towards full forward. Sumich going back on O'Reilly, and that's a very good mark. A lot of strength and evidence there. He's got one this afternoon from an errant kick-in. Great grab. It's a fine record against the Cats in finals. Going for his second here, but his 22nd and only his fourth final against Geelong. From point-blank range, he's got it. And you get the feeling this far from home, it's all over.
Great use of the body there by Peter Sumich. Strong player, Stephen O'Reilly. He's beaten Sumich in most one-on-one contests. But on this occasion, he got the big backside out the back, which shelved his arms a little bit. He was able to hug it into the chest.
Margin out to six goals. 12-18 to 7-12. 20 seconds remaining. And this is the third quarter. Bairstow to the pocket. Ablett with Brennan. Ablett tries to get it back. Brownless trapped it. Held up though by McIntosh. Djakovic just out of play. And that should be it. Looked for a moment as if it might have gone off his boot, out of bounds on the fall. But boundary umpire didn't see it that way. Barnes. And the siren sounds, and West Coast with 4 goals to Geelong's 2 in the third quarter have what would seem an unassailable lead. At three-quarter time in the grand final, West Coast 12-18-90, Geelong 7-12-54.
King Richard the Lionheart played 320 games for Essendon and is one of 4 men to have won 3 Brownlow medals. The captain of 4 premiership teams, Nick Reynolds will present the AFL Premiership Trophy to this year's winning captain and coach.
Tuesday, 8:30. Has a man been murdered? Or is it a spy who's been silenced?
What are your lawyers like?
Is this a threat?
Tony knows only one way to get to the answer.
Well, tough.
Between the Lines, 8:30 Tuesday. Then, on the heat.
It was more like an attempt to burn up evidence of a homicide.
Suspicions abound.
Do you think you've got some kind of scam going?
Setting off a chain reaction of fatal events. You'll experience the heat. Tuesday, 9:30 on Channel 7.
I used to hate going to the bank. We paid a fortune in fees, got nothing in return. Now, we get bonus interest, free legal advice, big discounts on travel, free accident insurance, and we can do everything we need over the phone.
We have a merit account.
A merit gold account? It's for people who don't like banking or banks.
This is Oasis. The refreshing fruit drinks nice tea is made with natural fruit juice. They say one drink and you escape to a tropical oasis. Aye, man. It works.
Hello, I'm John Hughes. Get a minimum of $2,000 for your old licence bomb, regardless of condition, as a trade-in on any one of my 450 used vehicles. If you're driving something that looks like this, and if you can afford to repay up to $75 per week without having to put any cash in, you can drive away in a late model vehicle such as a Magna, Laser or Falcon. Turn this into this for around $75 per week at Skipper Mitsubishi in Victoria Park and Titan Ford in Melville.
Back in the early days, the settlers who were trying to open up the Australian bush, one of the problems they had was how to stop their food going rotten. Because out here, it wouldn't last half a day in this heat. Well, necessity being the mother of invention, and Australians being a pretty inventive lot, they came up with this bright idea. Some people call it the Coolgardie Safe, and others, the Coolgardie Cooler. The trick is to keep the sides of the thing wet. Airflow causes evaporation, and that means heat exchange. It all works a bit like a refrigerator. Now, that might be okay for food, but when it comes to the really important things, you can't beat a car fridge. Doesn't get any better than this.
Cricket ground, West Coast 12-18, Geelong 7-12.
This match is part of the Fosters 1994 AFL Premiership season.
Lights have been turned on at the MCG just on the three-quarter time break. It's very dark and gloomy here, and very gloomy for Geelong. Now, a reminder about the mark of the year that you've taken part in that contest all day. We'll be announcing the winners at the conclusion of today's match. Well, Neil Curley and Dipper on the boundary line. Can the Cats resurrect something here, fellows?
Well, Bruce, I'd just about say it's a lost cause for Geelong. I don't know what Malcolm Blight can get out of these players. He's asked them for one last final effort. There's no positional moves he can make that turn this game around. It is now up to the players to show some real character and see if they can just prevent West Coast from making this a one-way traffic in the last quarter.
And for the West Coast, there's a bit of excitement in that huddle there three-quarter time, but I've got to remind them, back in 84, we were 5 goals up and got done by Essendon. This
and
game is
playing.
Of course they are, girls. But Mickey Malthouse just said to his players, look, boys, one quarter to go. You've got to keep your heads now, and important too, keep your feet, because it's a little bit slippery out here at the moment as well.
The big problem for Geelong is there's no midfielders or ball carriers coming through the centre. The West Coast boys are reading them, follow the ball, are much, much better. They're taking it off the packs, and they're creating run with their forward handball.
And once again, the West Coast defence has been outstanding. Guy McKenna, so far for me, is best on ground, and Djakovic is starting to get into the game. So, Bruce, I think we're looking forward to maybe an Eagles win here.
It looks that way. Thanks for that, Tipper, and also to Neil Curley. Well, Mark Besto will be disappointed today. 7 kicks, 5 handballs, caught a couple of times. But Dean Kemp will be delighted with what he's done.
Yeah, another brilliant third quarter after a terrific first half. He's totaled 18 and 5. He had 7 kicks in that quarter. But importantly, he ran with the football, set up a couple of goals, a brilliant pass into Chris Lewis, who converted. He is an outstanding player with a big future, and certainly he's got Brownlow medal written all over him.
Norm Smith as well.
Oh.
Now, just thinking, they've kept teams under 10 goals 11 times this year, West Coast. Geelong at 7. The defence is really symbolic today of what's happened for 24 matches throughout the year.
Well, the defence really starts in the middle, doesn't it? We've got six defenders plus everybody in the middle, probably bar Kemp, with a one-on-one role.
It's good beyond scary, that defence.
Start of the final term. Barnes, Gary Hocking, Bairstow. Sure, that's what Geelong were hoping for in their dreams last night. Barnes to Hocking to Bairstow as they exploded against Footscray in the opening match of the finals on the Saturday evening. Out of play.
It really was a body blow to Geelong. I guess the Eagles have had plenty of players on the bench that could cover perhaps any injury, but to lose Gary Hocking, their key midfielder, was really disastrous.
Bairstow, little handball, pressure from Mainwaring, and again out of play. Well, Michael Malthouse kept his players together for a long time at three-quarter time. Geelong were out there for about a minute, minute and a half, in position, trying to G one another up. West Coast as a group, maybe savouring the moment. I'm not sure if Mickey looks 30 minutes ahead. Evans, he does in his planning, but not emotionally perhaps, as Mainwaring's long kick. Hanley keeps it in, gets around ball that time. Back, Mainwaring. His ball again at about 65 metres to the point of the square. Waterman came from about 10 metres behind Sumich and O'Reilly and took an uncontested mark within 20 metres of goal.
Well, one of the great indicators of how good a side is to have a look at the calibre of the player on the bench. And Chris Waterman, who has probably only up until today had about 20 minutes on the ground in the finals, is just an outstanding player. He'd be one of the top liners at almost any other club.
It's missed a couple today, but his contribution has been significant. And from point blank range, puts through another one.
Geelong really have to find something as a team here. There really is a danger now that this game could break right open. Andrew Wills coming off the ground, and Lee Colbert having his first run on, which is good for him to get some finals experience, perhaps a future captain of the club. He lined up on Ashley McIntosh the last time they played. McIntosh started at centre half forward. Perhaps he would have had that role again today. McIntosh started in defence on Browns.
Turnbull and Barnes go at it again. It falls at their feet. This is Karch hurriedly onto the boot. Out wide, Matera leads in the race. Quiet afternoon for him. Matera with plenty of time. Kemp, anything but quiet, just forward of the wing. 23 possessions so far.
Three opponents and no slouches either. Pickering, Couch and Bairstow.
McKenna. They're toying with them now. This is Pike. Plenty of time. They'll contest about 20 metres out. Waiting behind. It's grabbed by Waterman. He gets another one.
everyone knows where the world's most famous French fries come from. The finest whole potatoes, of course, at McDonald's.
Life's like that in a Mitsubishi Lancer.
Well, since quarter time, West Coast have kicked 10 goals and Geelong have kicked 3. They're murdering them now. Bairstow out of the centre to full forward. Brennan tries a half volley. McKenna, who's played a superb game, to Jakovic, to Mainwaring. Turnbull's loose. It's all happening now. The spirit of Geelong, you feel, might have been well and truly broken. Turnbull to centre-half forward. Sumic sets into a ball again. Well, we knew he was a good player, but after today, he has elevated himself one notch in this grand final.
Big fly from the big fellow. He really has grown legs as the game has progressed. Play at any midfield position, up the back, up forward, and go into the ruck. He's done it all at various stages for the West Coast this year. And it's really ominous for all clubs in the competition at the depth of talent the West Coast have.
He's kicked one goal. He's kicked two goals. Well, he's one of six players out there today who weren't there in 1992. So this will be extra special, his first premiership. 15-18 to 7-12.
Good on him. I guess he was fighting with Jason Spinks for the extra tall position out on the ground. Also with Paul Harding at the start of the year. There weren't many positions available, but he's grabbed one and taken full toll of it.
Evans upended, looking at a free kick. And the clock is running slowly now for the Cats. It's gone. Pike out at the middle, down towards half forward. Sumic comes on a lead. Bounced obligingly for him. He's 45 metres out, turns. I think he's missed. Narrowly. Little Sumic. Two goals this afternoon. And the lead now, a massive one. 109 to 54. Here's Brown to put it in. Played so well against Carlton a couple of weeks back. Barnes wants it home, and why not? Brown goes in that direction. In fact, Handley chips in from the side. It's fisted away, taken by Heddy. Across to Evans, quick release. Kemp tried to soccer it. Pike's over the ball, a couple over him. It's locked in there somewhere. Out of bounds. The official attendance today, 93,860 at the MCG.
West Coast within about 45 metres of goal. Wilson thumps it towards the boundary line. Stephen Hocking and Chris Lewis out of play. Well, it's close to a full house. I can't see any vacant seats, but capacity at the MCG is supposedly 98,000. So not far short of that. Evans goes for it. And Brown, like a goalkeeper, takes the mark. 15-19 to 7-12. Since quarter time, West Coast have kicked 11-16 to 3-8. It's what they did to them in 92. They kicked 10 goals to 4 after half time. They've done the same thing. Gary Hocking to McGrath. At half back. Gets it in towards the centre square. Colbert from the side. Having his first run. Stephen Hocking flat footed. In trouble, takes a long time to get the handball away. Riccardi, Matera to try and run him down. Geelong go forward, Ablett the target. Hard at the back, still hard. Bouncing ball out of play. 8-5, named in the back pocket by the AFL All-Australian selectors this year.
Yeah. Changing fortunes, he played only 8 games last season. David Hart has started with West Perth back in, it was 82. Long time ago now. Out of defence, it swung towards the outer side and the mark is held by Chris Lewis. But doing as they like. I think it was Banfield who kicked it out there. Lewis goes in short. Pike has got it. Cross half back. 15-19 to 7-12. Name Waring up in front. Spent some time on the bench with what appeared to be a back injury. Tough time this for players of both sides. They know the results beyond doubt. Here's Ball, Handley, big fist away, back towards the wing. Brewer, away to Hocking, virtually on one leg. He kicks to the middle. Couch, he's tried pretty hard alongside the centre circle. Only his 15th possession. Here's Billy Brownless up ahead. Three goals this afternoon as Hines comes back onto the ground. Matera roving the pack, knocks it down. Awkward bounce for Couch. Matera with dash. Lost control of the ball. Steve Hocking falling to the ground. Got it out. Brewer, good evasion. Quick hands too. Gets it back to Brownless. Unloads for a big one. It's a shocker. It wobbles out wide. Attempt at the mark missed there by Minch. And Jakovic comes away. Jakovic at left half back. Three bounces. Kicks towards half forward. In from the side. Mansfield. He's taken the mark, but there was going to be a free kick. We'll go Geelong's way, and Mansfield paid a price there. Had he heard the whistle a little bit earlier, it may have saved him.
And here's Mansfield, great grab, almost hurt himself. Surprised to see Mansfield not perhaps given a run up forward in the second half. Geelong had nothing to lose, could have maybe thrown their side around a little bit, have maintained their predictable lineup.
McGrath to full forward, Ablett at the back, McIntosh chance now for Ablett in the pocket. He didn't realise he had a bit more room than he had. 33 years of age today, and not much more to celebrate for Gary Ablett. Had no impact at all on this game. McKenna, I mean, dare you say it, but he actually has played like a 33-year-old today. Pike at half-back. Mainwaring was on the other side of the ground a moment ago. Centering kick to full forward. Hanley went at it hard with Brown. Heady got a boot in there with McGrath out of play. Wills, who excited Geelong early, he was, I think, a catalyst when they kicked those four goals in 7 minutes. Hanley and Ball, Evans and Hocking. What a disappointment for Buddha today. Unable to give his best because of an injury when he was tripped in the first quarter. Mark Bairstow gets it from Hocking. Blazes away. Hines. Paddock here. This is where Pike loves to run into a bit of space. Great tagger, but he finds space so well. Evans normally goals from this situation. He's got it. It's another one. He's third.